Hello everyone, welcome to part 8 of my Rockdale project. This time I'm going to play around a bit with industry specialization. It's apparently a simple thing that we can do. As you've seen so far, you can completely ignore it. So first off, I need to find my resources. So here is a good spot for forestry. And it looks like I've got some fertile land. Also in the city limit. Those are renewable resources. Oil and ore, they run out eventually. I'm not actually going to deal with those ones. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is first I have to make a district. So over here, I'll have the forestry district. Yeah, Poplar Heights works. Then what I'm going to do is look at policies. Whoops. Okay, I might need to put some industry in there first, but maybe I don't have the Now I have the specialization, so okay, so what I'm going to do First, I'm gonna need a road in here. So, I'm gonna build a road. Let's see. I guess I need some ramps too. Okay, so now I can get into the forest area. Oops. Built the wrong kind of road. That's better. Now I'm going to actually use Let's do this again. Okay, I'm going to use gravel roads here. And this is going to have to be zoned industrial. And I'm obviously going to need some services in here. And clearly, I'll need some electricity as well. Ah, right. You got to put the right kind of district in there. Okay, come on, fill in over here. There we go. Oops. Okay, let's see how. Okay. You know, I think whoops. I think a cargo station would be a good thing over here. Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Five, six, seven, eight. Two, 3, 4, 5, 6. Four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. Okay, so this industry specialization lark seems to be working quite well. Okay. Over on this side, I think I'll put up a small village. After all, people do prefer to work closer to where they live. Okay. gotta actually provide services. Yeah, it helps if you build the grid in the direction you're intending to. Now, let's see. Make sure the power doesn't break here. And add some more residential here. Now, what are these zots about? Ah, not enough workers. Okay. You know, I think it would be a good idea to bring some transit in. Oops, I need to actually make a line. Okay. Okay, hopefully that'll bring some additional workers down. Huh. Apparently, death rate is exceeding the birth rate. That might be my problem. Wonder if the health thing was part of the problem. Okay. Okay, clearly I have a trash problem. Yeah, I really need to get this to flip around. Okay, it may just be I have to wait out the imbalance with the high percentage of seniors in the population. Okay. Oh, it's still the wrong way around. Though I do have in-migration working in my favor. Currently. Whoops. Okay. Nah, I don't need to pause that. I'm gonna save it though. Okay. Right, okay. Okay. I can bring this in here now. And remove this run. Okay. Okay. I guess I should move the line to the new stop here. We'll see if the people will live by a rail line. Well, the senior population is decreasing, but things seem to still be lopsided. Oh, maybe I've got it turned around now. Oh, my employment level's improving. I think I should construct a power plant. Let's look at the water situation. Yeah, it's getting iffy. Okay. Okay, that should be good there. Okay. Okay. Okay, so that's improving. Let's take a look in here again. Yeah. Okay, the senior population percentage is down. Children percentage is up. I think the children percentage needs to be higher yet, but that will change, I think, with time. So the lesson to be learned here is that you can't go all high density residential, or you can't get too much of that, or you don't get families. Okay. Okay. Okay, and I think before I call this apart, I'm going to turn this into a district. That's a cute name, Underhill Heights. Let's look at the demographics here. So basically, I've got a quarter of the population is teenagers and children. About two-thirds is adults, and the rest is seniors. Okay, I'm starting to get an unemployment problem here. So, that may be partly down to transportation, but it might also be lack of desired jobs. If the population gains continue the way they're going, I might make the next milestone before I end the part. Now, one of the problems over here is overeducated workers, so they're going to easily leave and, emigrate or select less menial jobs, I guess. So that's one of the problems when you have your education too high over the whole city. So crime looks okay. Oh, we're exporting forest products. Okay, I'm going to. Gonna see if adding some commercial improves the demand equation a bit. See if I can convince more of my people to stay. There we go. Now I'm up to a colossal city. And I'm going to call it a part there. So, first up, I need to save the game. Okay, everyone, that's it for part 8. I'll see you all back in part 9. Thanks for watching.